So in the previous videos, we used statistical inference to make comparisons across different models. So we had models that were already fit to a given data set. Now we will consider statistical tests using statistical inference to do comparisons for algorithms. So that means we can compare models that have been fit to different training sets or training subsets. And this is here focusing on statistical inference, so some statistical tests. And I will only list the tests that exist and just give you some pros and cons and links to more material. I've written about that in more detail in the lecture notes. And then in the next section, we will take a look at a computational way for comparing algorithms. So what is the motivation behind algorithm selection? So aside from, of course, publishing papers, and so what would be the real world application of that? So remember, I remember that I talked about a case where we developed, let's say, an email application, and the email application has a machine learning algorithm that learns based on the user behavior to identify spam and non-spam for that user. So in that case, we want to ship an algorithm that can learn well on email data. So we may want to compare different algorithms on different training sets and see which one performs best in a practical scenario. Another case would be archive sanity. This is, I think it's called archive sanity preserver, actually. So I don't remember right now the detailed or the exact web address, but if you search on that on the web, I think you will find it. So this is like a layer on top of a web application on top of archive.org, which is a server for hosting preprints. So preprints are articles. So traditionally, these are articles that have not been published yet or not been peer reviewed yet. So for example, if you would write a paper and the journal or conference allows it, then you can post an early version of your article before it has been reviewed and before it has been accepted. Nowadays, it's also sometimes common to post a preprint, like a manuscript version, after the article has been accepted or after the article has even been published. So this is usually so that other people can access the article, because sometimes it takes a while until or after acceptance until the article is published, let's say in the conference proceedings. And some journals, they charge substantial amounts of money for accessing an article. So not everyone has, let's say, a subscription for that journal. So in that way, people who don't have a subscription can also read the article for free. So archive, we have actually a lot of preprints every day, like hundreds of machine learning papers. I'm one of the moderators there, like helping, taking a look at whether the submissions look good. And it's actually a very interesting thing to do, because you see all the interesting titles every day uploaded, so you get an idea what's currently trendy in machine learning or machine learning research. But we usually have around 1 to 200 articles each day. And the Archive Sanity Preserver is a web application. I think it's developed by Andrei Karpathy. And it uses a support vector machine for each user. You can create an account, and then the support vector machine learns from papers you like. So you can like papers and search for similar papers, and the support vector machine, there's one for each user, it will learn from your behavior and then make recommendations of articles you might be interested in. So in that case here, it was also important to select a good algorithm that is maybe fast but then also accurate when it learns from the user behavior. So that would be a case where algorithm selection would be an interesting topic for developing such an application. Okay, so that was a long speech. So here is an overview of different techniques, statistical tests. So it's a paper by Tom Dieterich, who is also one of the moderators on Archive. So the article is already 20 years old, but it's still a good summary, because these are, I would say, the major techniques you would think about if you have taken other statistical or statistics classes and you wonder, can we apply this statistics test to machine learning? So McNamara's test, we talked about that before. This is actually not an algorithm comparison test, it's just a model comparison test, but still interesting to list here, because based on the study on empirical experiments, Tom Dieterich found that it has a low false positive rate, and it's actually also fast to run, which is nice if we compare two models to each other. There are other tests. For example, the difference in proportions test, it has unfortunately a high positive rate though. tests that require fitting multiple models. So this would be more the case for algorithm selection or comparison, at least. Let's call that algorithm comparison here. These ones, they require fitting multiple models, but if they are more accurate, they're actually quite useful. So here, this one, unfortunately, the resampled pair t-test has a high false positive rate, and similar to the repeated holdout method, it can be computationally expensive because we have to fit it to multiple training sets. A better method is the k-fold cross-validated t-test, but unfortunately, it also has a slightly elated false positive rate. So with that, wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis, even though the null hypothesis is true. And another method is the 5x2 cross-validated paired t-test. This is a technique that was proposed in this paper. And this one has a low false positive rate. So that is nice. It's similar to McNamara's test, and it's a little bit lower, I think. And what's also nice, it's slightly more powerful than McNamara's test. So statistical power would be rejecting the null hypothesis if the alternative hypothesis is true. So correctly rejecting the null hypothesis. So kind of detecting that there is a difference. So correctly detecting the difference, that would be the statistical power. And this one would be one nice test to consider. There are some newer, better approaches. For example, there's also a 5x2 CV paired F-test. Oh, sorry, not a paired F-test. We can call it like that. There are also other methods. I have written about this a little bit more in the lecture notes. So like before, we won't go into all the details about all the statistical tests, but for those who are interested in that, can read the lecture notes. And that's what I'm saying here. And also, I implemented most of them in MLExtend, so the McNamara's test, Cochrane's Q test, the resampled pair t-test, which is actually not recommended, but for educational purposes, I implemented that here, the k-fold cross-validated pair t-test, 5x2 CV pair t-test, recommended in Tom Diedrich's paper, regular f-test, and also the 5x2 CV combined f-test. I would say, an improved version over the 5x2 CV paired t-test. So I don't know why I put this one in here, probably a copy-paste thing. So I would recommend also looking at this one if you want to compare different models to each other. So this is based on refitting a model to different training sets. So technically, to be correct, it would be more like an algorithm comparison. But yeah, this is also something worthwhile to consider. It would be a good case for algorithm comparison using statistical inference. And in the next video, we will take a look at algorithm selection and comparison using a computational or empirical approach.